So let's start by calculating the final kinetic energy using mgh for the gravitational potential energy. So once again, we start with conservation of energy, the idea that the kinetic energy and the potential energy always add up to the same value no matter what point we're at in our experiment. Now we know that the ball starts off with no initial velocity, so we can say that the initial kinetic energy is zero, and we know that the ball lands on the ground at height zero, so the final potential energy is also zero. So this gives us that the final kinetic energy is just equal to the original potential energy, which is equal to mgh, and plugging in the values 50 meters, 9.8 meters per second squared, and 1 kilogram, we get that the final kinetic energy is 490 joules. Now let's repeat that calculation, except this time we'll use the more general formula for gravitational potential energy. So once again, we start with conservation of energy. And just like last time, the initial kinetic energy is zero. Now this time we can't say that the final potential energy is zero, because our formula is slightly different. In fact, this formula is only ever equal to zero when r gets really large. And that's not going to happen any time in our problem. So we can't ever say that the potential energy is zero, but we can still do the math. And solving for final kinetic energy, we get that it's the difference between the original potential energy and the final potential energy. And we can plug in our formula for those to get this equation. And inserting our known values into this equation, we get that the final kinetic energy using this version of the gravitational potential energy is 486 joules. Not bad, that's actually quite close to 490. And using these values to calculate a percent error, I get that my percent error for the final kinetic energy is 0.76%. That's not bad at all. So really, mgh is pretty good for calculating gravitational potential energy over distances like 50 meters. But as we'll see later, if we need to do much larger distances, we'll have to use this version of gravitational potential energy.